lovely title bar for the old world. It just takes me back. And that map, it's not very familiar to me, is it you?
Yeah, I mean, this map is a really detailed, beautiful map of the old world. And as they're using the newer map that they've made for it, it's just zooming in and zooming in and zooming in. Super cool. Really, really impressive. And what I like most about this logo actually is if you look deeply into it, then the then that dark, yeah, that dark line that's going across it is a battle line with siege towers and
Ooh.
banners. Yeah, super cool.
Yeah, some big dudes like a troll or something.
There's a proper battle line on the actual line of non-metallic metal. You've got
Yes.
a Warhammer. Super cool.
It's
Nice.
actually SENMM, Sky
There
Earth Non-Metallic Metal. That's a
you go.
thing.
It is, it's a real
You
thing.
know it. You knew it, you forgot for a minute. And look, in this bottom one, there's like a demon army. So that's almost like there's the army on the front and there's the army facing them. I love that. Yeah, I didn't even notice.
I'll
So
have to get my glasses out to see it, but yeah,
get
it's
your
definitely
magnifying lens.
put the old man glasses on.
We're getting more from the old world. And this miniature, I'll just give you my impression, then I want to hear your impression, John. This to me is almost a perfect looking fella. Like the silhouette of this with the non, he hasn't even got a, they normally carve on the logos and the iconography, but this looks freehanded, so you've got all that space to play. Painter's dream, painted and really amazing. I mean, he's stoic, he's that static commander pose. Yeah, I think this is a badass model. I think this is my favorite one so far.
Yeah, this is one of the new Cities of Sigmar miniatures, which is for Age of Sigmar. It's their kind of follow-up to, it used to be just like a collection of old Empire stuff from Warhammer that never left the range. It kind of just stayed there. And now we saw the last time we sat down and talked, we saw the knights, and now we're seeing these fellas, and they're perfect. Like you said, they're amazingly well sculpted. There's lots of space to put details in. I can see people using them in Warhammer, the Old World. I can see people using them in 40K as Inquisitors and whatever, rogue traders and stuff like that, Imperial Crusaders. I just think they're amazing and they've got a lot of scope.
Yeah,
Really well.
this one on the right here has definitely got an Inquisitor vibe, I think, just because of the, that's like Archaeotech pistol style.
I
And the
think they're
faces are
actually all
good.
the same, aren't they? They're the same miniature, but
Oh,
they're built in different. If you
is
look
this
at
one
it,
kit?
yeah, look at it. It's if you
Ah,
look at the cloak,
yes.
and the arm where the sleeve joins the pistol and where the sleeve joins the sword, it's the same miniature.
Oh, wow. Good spot. I didn't
Yeah,
see
really,
that.
really cool. Really cool. It's got lots of configurations. I think it's really smart.
I
I'm
mean,
definitely getting myself one.
you're getting them.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. I
In.
think they'd be really good in my 40K Agents of the Imperial Army. Yeah.
It's just, I mean, that's testament. It's either testament to my poor perceptive skills or how amazing the design elements are from Heavy Metal Team, because I couldn't tell, a change in color, a change in two or three arms, and
Yeah.
he sorry, head swap and arms, boom, you get a completely different impression, or at least I did.
Yeah, and if you go back to the previous slide, you'll see that it's the same miniature that it's just got a different head. So yeah, it's the same, and it comes with a little boy holding a sort of flagpole or something.
Everyone needs a
Super cool.
familiar. Every
Yeah,
army needs a familiar. A
someone
sly
who's
kick.
a sidekick, someone to kick.
I just love it, man. Yeah, and these could even be old Caliban Dark Angels, pre-Emperor.
Yeah, I
Where, you know,
agree.
when
Yeah.
Caliban is just knights going out, next to old Lionel Johnson.
Yeah,
A Luther, a
they have
Lutherite.
so many things you can do with them.
So many
I'm
things.
looking forward to getting my hands on them. Like I say, mine will find their way into the 41st millennium, I'm sure.
When they get into your sweaty palms, there is no issue with what could happen to them.
Oh, goodness me, they're gonna go
There's
crazy, aren't they?
you're gonna go crazy. Ah, there's the squire and
There he
the
is.
original guy. Or is it?
Yeah.
He's got another configuration.
Yeah, it's the same one again, but he's got leaning on his hammer and he's got his helmet under his arm casually. But I think his head is brilliant. I love his haircut. Look around the back of him, he's got like all shaved up underneath. It's really, really well done.
Night croppings.
Yes.
And that squire, he's got some kind of zombie or dead victim. I
In a
guess it's
box.
have his head in a box. What more do you want? It's the guy that his champion killed.
What's in the box? It reminds me of that moment in Seven, where somebody's head in a box. But yes, it's obviously something squires need to do. Carry a head around with you until you're until you can become a proper knight.
He is a very serious squire. Look at that. Look at that intent face. The faces are really good, actually. Really cool.
Yeah, lovely models. Lovely, lovely models. Looking forward to them.
Age of Sigmar. Let's go. What's new in Sigmar?
Well, we're still talking about the Warhammer of the Old World. There was a recent announcement, and they were talking about which factions are going to be supported from the outset and which will go immediately to PDF mm-hmm. rules. And there's been quite a bit of chat about it online. So I just wanted to mention it. It looks like we're going to have the Orcs and Goblins, Empire, Bretonnia, Tomb Kings, Chaos Warriors, High Elves, Wood Elves, and Dwarfs, I think, from the outset. But no Skaven, no Dark Elves. No, because and no demons. They're just and no Lizardmen. So they're either these armies are too far away from the old world setting, or
geographically,
or they're just not on the rise at that particular time in the history that they want to set it in. And they haven't said that they will bring them in, and they haven't said that they won't.
Interesting.
But they have said that from the outset, all the armies playable in 8th edition will be playable. There'll be free rules for them. But the ones that they're mainly focused on at the beginning are those ones I just mentioned. So that caused quite a bit of online chatter. I'm not particularly worried about it. I think what will be, and just enjoy it as it comes.
We'll see what happens. And that leaves them open, right, to roll out the different races as the timeline progresses, as the narratives progress. So it's a cool thing. I mean, the beginning of Sigmar, it was just really chaos and Sigmar, Knights of Sigmar, right? So Stormcast. Yeah. So I guess that's going to, give them scope to carry on.
Well, yeah, of course. And I hope it all goes very well and we go out and we invest in it, because that will help it to pick up off the ground and give it a future.
So, hold back. Don't throw your armies away yet, those who are not being covered. Let's see what happens.
Exactly. Keep them. They're very precious.
Very precious.
They are.
So quite limited amount we've got to show this week. For Sigmar, we've got this little team of ghosties. These may have actually been released before, but not as a box. I think they're coming now in, whereas you could only previously get them in, I think, Age of Darkness or one of the releases, the Nighthaunt releases.
Okay, yeah. So some kind of box game release or whatever. Yeah. I really like the one with the naughty list.
you can see him. He's in front of someone's like, I'm not on the naughty list. He's like, here, yes you are. Yes, you are. You didn't brush your teeth and now you got a cavity that's killed you. Now you're on my list.
It is wonderful. There's one with a naughty list. And the other one is kind of dragging his sword through the smoke at the bottom there. That one's very cool as well.
Yeah, the mask on that is amazing.
I'm very impressed with the naughty list.
That says haunt to me. And this is actually my favorite, the anvil. I mean, it's the juxtaposition of this sort of ethereal, weightless, formless night haunt and the heaviest thing you'd see in an Acme cartoon. It's just like, and just in case you doubted it was being dragged, there's a candle on top just to show you that it's definitely being balanced. I mean, that's so cool, isn't it? And the back guy, he's actually polishing his weapon, if we can say such a thing. And if you're gonna is he really doing a great job? Because it looks rusted to shit.
He might be adding more rust to it.
Or poison. It could be a poison bar.
Yeah, he could be rubbing it with poison, exactly. So we've got them all busy doing something. Hefting anvils or compiling a naughty list or whatever. But yeah, they're all busy doing something. I love them. They've got a lot of character.
It's just crazy, isn't it? Because it's the same as the Zinjian guys we saw last week. These releases of a little group can really just rush past you, but they're all like individual characters or diorama pieces unto themselves. It's just an unbelievable release, really. I mean, if I had time, I would smash out an army of these,
I think it would be quick and easy to paint them as well. And this kind of style of design work is brilliant, because it gives your creative team an avenue to just explore different aspects of something. It's like, okay, just make three or four really cool miniatures related to this, So you can explore different directions, which is what they've been
Mm-hmm.
doing. It's like little crab familiars and parrots and strange things that we might not necessarily have seen before with concentrated army releases. But these Warhammer Underworld warbands and Kill Team and War Cry, all these little skirmish
Yeah.
games, they're great for the design team and just to explore their creativity and their genius. It's lovely.
Love the underworld underwears. Well,
Underwear.
what's on the rumor engine? So this is a new thing I'm going to do with you, John. I'm going to flip the switch on what on the rumor engines, and you're going to tell me what it is because you have insider knowledge. Let's see the first
Oh,
one.
yeah. Do you
Hey.
know what? I think that's something for a guy. It looks like the first 15 seconds of the 18.
Or it's somebody's bed has got really bad woodworm and they've stuffed pillows to hide it.
It could be if you were sleeping on sandbags, yeah.
Don't know.
Who knows? Who knows? But yeah, it's Imperial
It's
Guard.
bullets, right? So it's
Character.
not Sigma, it's not possibly Sigma, but not really at that rate of firing.
No, I think it's a guard thing, and I think it's what do I think it is? I hope it's Catachan stuff or Valhallan stuff or Talarn stuff or something which is, or even Krieg. They made some plastic ones for Kill Team. There's definitely people out there who bought Krieg over the years. It could be a very big demand for it. So, yeah, something guardy, I would
Shooty
say.
Rockcrete.
Yeah.
Okay, spiky. Let's say this is a spiky armadillo who likes to shoot bow and arrows. There we go.
Armadillo cloak. Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks like an armadillo or a porcupine kind of spines, but I think they're knives that have been wedged through a piece of cloth.
In seriousness,
So,
goblins with the
could well
arrows,
be.
a little
Yeah.
shaman cloak, possibly
Yeah.
black.
I think that on the roadmap for Age of Sigmar, the Gloomspike kits are getting a bit of an update
All right,
soon.
you're
So,
cheating. No, we don't, we're not
it's good to
cheating on
know
this. We're going with what we feel. Not with I've seen the
that.
roadmap. John, you're giving
Yeah.
away your insider secrets. Okay, is this a loyalist piece of metal? No.
I wouldn't have thought so. No, it's almost going to speak to you, isn't it? It's so chaotic.
It's
But
so
yeah.
chaos. It's like Lorgar's steering wheel.
Lorgar's
That's codpiece. Spiky
codpiece.
chaos. It could be from anywhere, right? This could be in any world in any game, but
Generic chaos. Yeah, there we go. It's chaos as chaos can be. 8-pointed silver
chaosify
star.
me, mummy.
Yeah.
Right. This is Lorgar's codpiece.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't.
Lorgar's top
Could be anyone's. I
gun.
mean, that almost looks like no line I know. Maybe the haft of a Necron. After a Necron weapon, that's all I could say. See.
What I look at it is, as I see it sort of tapering off towards the top, it looked to me like it was a whip. So it could be some kind of Dark Eldar whip kind of.
Dark Elder homunculi tool, but either way, we will check back on these when we know.
Bit probe.
You and your probes. Right, what have we got for the Horus hearsay?
Do we have for the hearsay? Yeah.
Oh, shooty man, tank gunner boy. I love
Another
this.
great editor.
I
Yeah.
always loved a gunner. This is, I think it really splits people. It's the Marmite conundrum, isn't it? People either
It
like,
is.
it's ridiculous, even though I play in a far future, fantastical, high gothic setting, it's
Yeah.
ridiculous to have a man shouting at the top of a tank. Other people are like, yeah, that's metal. That's raw. And clearly he's taken some beatings from being that gunner. Because look at his arm or what was left of it.
Yeah.
50, he's got good 80s hair. You know, he's shooting the assault cannon, so it puts us firmly back in, Kerris pattern times before it was massive Primaris with big shooty loaders. I love it.
Yeah.
I love this whole thing.
Yeah, I think the reason he's a tank gunner is because he's probably been messed up in battle. And he's got his bionics, his half his head's been torn off, he's got killer haircut, he's got his bionic arm. So yeah, he's a vehicle gunner. Who knows, he might not even have any legs. They haven't bothered sculpting any. So he's kind of just be like stuck in your tank turret. I love him. I think he's brilliant. I think his head is great to use on other conversions. And I do like the heresy stuff with all the filigree and the extra detail on the armor. Like you say, they're not as clean cut as the Primaris. They're much more ornate, and they're more ornate than 40K Marines. So yeah, very, very
Getting
cool
there.
indeed.
He is
Yeah,
one
Gatling guns.
hunter killer missile away from being interned in the dreadnought, right? I mean,
Yeah,
literally,
exactly.
everything's about to fall out.
That would be the progression, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Marine, then mangled up tank gunner, and then dreadnought.
Yeah.
That's his career
And then
path.
somebody much sort of the other end, someone much more sort of in some ways hierarchically, quite pristine. Same
Yeah, he's very
army.
clean, isn't he? He's very clean.
He's there for
He's
Dawn. He's here for it. But he
yes.
is, about to smite somebody. And really, I think one of the first times we've seen an official model with the beaky helm, right?
Yeah, he's probably going to have an alternative head, as they normally do with the Forge World sculpt, with no helmet. But I think he's great, and I like these these Mark VI beaky armors with the big round collar. One of the leaders in the Age of Darkness box has got this kind of armor, and they just look wide
Love him.
and really cool. Yeah, I love it. I love he's got no nonsense. He's smooth, he's clean, and he's ready to go, isn't he? Look at him.
Wicked paint job too. I mean, the blue is just gorgeous. I mean, it looks like a ultramarine-esque, macrag blue, cantar blue kind of mix up. Got a little soft dark shading. And he's got his, I love the Romanesque flick of the, it's quite a heavy cloak, so that's a choice, but still it kind of works for him, and the axe is clean. Yeah, really, if I was painting that, I wouldn't change much as a converting.
I would probably paint it as a different legion. Probably go with Sons
Would
of
you go?
Horus. Yeah, either that or Word Bearers. I kind of like the dark red on the Word Bearers. But yeah, he is very cool. He is very, very cool. And magic is blue, or it's kind of like a lava color, isn't it? So I'd probably go with a more kind of red or yellow magic. But
Oh,
yeah, I
magic.
think it's very
He's a
magic.
lovely, lovely option if you want a librarian in Horus Heresy. What's going on in Warhammer 40K at the moment, John? So much that we wish we had a whole other episode. We do. It's the Leviathan glow up episode. So check it out. But pulling away from Leviathan, we got this guy. This was a sort of this was a bit of a curveball for me when I saw him. I was like, I know that character.
Yeah, he's lieutenant. I think he used to be a captain, then he went to the Death Watch, he got busted down to lieutenant, and his name is Titus or Titus.
Titus.
Yeah, Titus. He's the Space Marine computer game character, isn't he?
That's the one. So he's
What
one
do you
of.
think of him? What's your opinion on him?
I mean, I just loved the Space Marine game because it was the first game I played where I was like, oh my God, I feel like I could sort of, the game feel was like being a Marine. So to actually have a model of him is very cool. The only thing is they've made him Primaris and the game version was a bit leaner. And so I think he's lost a bit of mobility with that, with the big knee discs. But apart from that, very cool, very ultramarine, very courage of McCrag. Face is cool, face scale is really cool. Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot.
Cool. Yeah, I can see definitely some applications for this miniature, and it'll probably be very popular. Like you say, many people have a lot of love for Space Marine computer games. So I can see it doing well whatever they decide to do with it. I don't know whether it's actually going to be on general release or whether it's a special edition.
Yes, you do. You know, John, why you pretend you don't have all the information already? Every time with this.
They download it into my brain
Yeah,
through the warp.
through the specs.
Yeah.
Boys,
These are
the boys are
cool. Look at these.
back.
Look at
So this
these
was a
guys.
Japanese limited release. And they were kind of one of these blind buys where you could buy a box and not know which one you got. There was a release. So this came out on pre-order, I think 2 weeks ago, and was gone. It was gone in minutes. I didn't get a box. I'm so disappointed. I really wanted it. And the playcaster at the front there is really why, because he was in a separate set originally, the paint set in Japan. And he was going for hundreds on eBay just a few weeks ago. So, and I think he is probably the coolest playcaster model in the Death Guard range. The flow of the miniature is incredible. The energy, the flies, Just everything about it. I've got all the other guys, but that's the one I wanted. Please,
Well,
somebody send me him.
exactly. They are the nicest, aren't they? They're the nicest Plague Marines, I think, the whole lot. I mean, the Plague Marine range is really cool. I think these are just really nice. Something about their faces and the heads on them, they're really well done. They're really, really well done. They're
My
more aligned
faves,
with the
this
Sigma.
guy, simple.
It's got like a skull face, that one, right?
Skull face, and this
Yeah.
one with the other helm. I like this guy
Yeah.
too because he's kind of about to literally going to throw a grenade. He's off balance.
He's got plague
These three
grenade,
are cool
hasn't he?
too, but those four. What's your favorite?
I like the one on the top left-hand corner from where I'm looking at it. So the one with the skull face is my favorite. This one up here, yeah. Just like him.
Glotticus, I think. They've all got names as well.
Yeah. So if someone can send you the play caster, someone else can send me that one.
Someone
I'll
send me
be happy.
that and we'll exchange many good things with you.
Deep secrets.
Deep secrets and wonderful mysteries. So yeah, that's the box it came in Japan and maybe now here too. And see, this is the guy that I want, just in case it wasn't clear. Okay, and finally we've got the free mini of the month. So each month you can go to GW store and get a free mini. Not many people know this. And those are the two they're giving away at the moment. So really cool for new players, anyone new to this hobby, go down there and say and blame the Sprue review and say they said you'd give me free toys. And we will take no responsibility for that.
We always did it though. We always did it when we worked in the stores. We had like Space Marines, and they would send us a box of Space Marines every month, and we'd teach people to paint with them, and that was effectively giving somebody a free miniature, wasn't it? Painting lessons. So yeah, I'm super happy that they continue with those things, and the miniatures they're giving away are not like just a standard Marine. They are kind of more in keeping with or in line with the new releases. So
Yeah,
yeah,
this is in
Saurus
the box
World,
set.
super cool, and a Termagant. They're just really, really good miniatures, no? And I think anybody from a new beginner to somebody who's more veteran would be happy to have that. Pop into your store on a Saturday and you pick up one of those. It's just brilliant. What a lovely gesture.
We love that gesture. So that's a Sauron, is it?
Yeah, it's a Saurus, what, from the Seraphon, isn't it? It's a Saurus warrior of the Age of Sigma. Massive dinosaur man, angry. Cool
They're almost
weapon.
like cousins, aren't they, from different timelines?
Yeah, they kind of took off, didn't they, in the end times, in their ziggurats, and sort
Yeah.
of flew off into space, and then came back again as the Seraphon. So
Oh,
yeah,
right. Nice. Yeah, I know nothing
they're
about that race. That's cool to learn. Thank you. But they've both
Yeah.
got teeth and claws and scales. And this is the Dune Stealer cult thing.
Yeah, there you go. So yeah, they could be related, couldn't they? Seeing them together on the same page, they could have like
Not
distant
saying they're
relations.
related, but yeah, you know.
Well, the old ones would have created the Saurus, and who knows, maybe they had a hand in the Tyranids as well, being a cosmic, godlike
Forefathers.
being creation. Yeah, exactly. Who knows? Who knows? Maybe they invented the Tyranids, and it was a big mistake.
Amazing. That's all for Warhammer 40K.
Yeah.